for reference. Okay, let it start. Okay, fine. Yes. So, yeah, TAs may please confirm if it is visible.
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Okay. So the only thing which I missed out in the morning was marking the access properly, and which is where the confusion came up. So now, whatever the flux pattern which I wanted to showcase, that when we have three-phase balance system and we are giving a supply which is also like balanced, and we have a space distribution of the coils, so we have the rotating air gap flux. This is what I wanted to showcase. Now here I will quickly just show that thing, and then we will move towards the assignment part. So we saw that this is what typically we have on per phase basis. If we take the individual phases, these are the fluxes which we are having, and these are of course pulsating in nature. So now when we have pulsating fluxes and we do the space distribution, what we get basically? So step by step we were seeing what is the value of different flux components, and then we can see what it is going to give us. So let's say at omega t equal to 0, if we take, then we have the phi r value equal to 0, phi y value equal to some minus phi naught times of root 3 by 2, and phi b value is equal to phi naught root 3 by 2. So if you just mark where these quantities are falling on these axes, so phi r, see this axis when I'm marking, this is very important thing to understand. The axis of the flux, which you may call the axis of the coil also. So you can see from the right hand thumb rule, when you go rotate your fingers, the thumb in that direction it is pointing, that is the direction of the flux. So for r, then this is the direction of the axis, then for y it is here, and b it is here. So now the value of r over here is 0, and the value of y is minus phi naught root 3 by 2. So minus means which is along the negative axis. So we have to mark it somewhere here, 0.866 times. And then we have b, which is positive, and it has value phi naught root 3 by 2. So again, it comes along the positive axis. So this is coming somewhere here. So when you sum this vectorially, of course you will get a net vector which will be along this axis. And this will have magnitude of 3 by 2 times of phi naught. So this is what I was saying. When we have omega t equal to 0, typically our flux is located on this axis, and this is where our theta equal to 0 starts. Now from here, it will rotate in the counterclockwise direction. So let's see a couple of more instances how it is doing. Again, now if we take, let us say the instant omega t equal to pi by 2, what we have basically phi r, which is having the maximum value phi naught, and phi y and phi b, these both are minus phi naught by 2 and minus phi naught by 2. So this is the value. Now again, if you mark, now this is your phi r that is coming, and then you have other two, let's say y, which is along the negative axis. So this is the positive axis of flux, y flux, and so it is coming over here, half phi by 2 somewhere here, and then we have the b, which is negative, so this will also come along this pi by 2. And if you add all these three again vectorially, then it will come along the y axis, along the r axis, and this will have value of 3 phi naught by 2. So now which was the flux which was here at theta equal to 0, now it is here at theta equal to 90 degree. So we see that tendency to rotate with time because of this spatial distribution. So one more instant we can see quickly, and then we can do a couple of more exercises on our own. So let's say omega t equal to 2 pi by 3. That time our phi r will be plus k root 3 by 2 or phi naught root 3 by 2, and phi y will be 0, phi b will be minus phi naught root 3 by 2. Again, if you mark, the phi r is root 3 by 2 something like here. The b and y is 0 of course, so it is at the origin here. The b is along the negative b axis, so which is coming over here. Sorry, this is the wrong line. Yes, so it should come here. So our net flux will come along this 3 by 2 times of phi naught. So again at theta equal to 120 degree, it is here. So from here it started 0 degree, and then at theta equal to 90 degree here, and then at theta equal to 120 degree it is here. So this is what we see as the rotating flux or rotating MMF or any quantity which you want to correlate with this. So this has this tendency, so which is what I wanted to showcase in the morning. So other things, let us say a few more instances you can do on your own, and then you can understand how this thing is happening, because this has very strong correlation with the space vector PWM, which I indicated in the morning also. So this is the basis of what we do essentially in a space vector PWM, and we realize the rotating vector with the switching vectors. So this is what we have. So I think now this is clear to all of you. You can unmute your mic and you can say.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So then I will stop the recording here.